I just use my optimizer and try to see the mold line. So what I usually do, I take one of these I think they're pens for graphic artists. These are alcohol based. One is pretty flat, okay, and the other one is round and sharp. And what I usually do, I take this one, try to look about seam lines, and I just mark them, okay. You can also smell the alcohol. Okay, so that is here as usual. This must be better. So you just mark all these seam lines. Is actually a lot of seam lines hidden actually here, so this is very useful to have the optimizer. Okay. So there's one which is across here. Okay, that one here. Okay, this is the first try. So then what I usually do, I take my some sanding sticks I have, this is bit rough. I will start with this one. I think the not too hard, and then try to work them out. The idea is that when you remove the color, the seam line is gone, but this is not always the case, and I found out that especially for Hasegawa and Tamiya kits, you think that the seam line is gone, okay? You have, you know, sand them flat, this color is not there, then you start priming, and then it pops up again. And then what you do, you just put some filer, sand them again, you repeat the process, and then when you prime them, you have the same problem. Seam line pops up. This has happened to me in many kits, so you have to be patient correcting all the seam lines, because even if it is not there in the priming step, you can find them, you know, the hard way when you paint them. Then seam lines pops up, and then this is real, it's a problem there. I use this sanding sticks first, but then I'll use also some Tamiya sponges with 600, 800. You do it slowly because you don't want to remove any important structure if there's there. Apart from these seam lines, there is some flash, okay, but it's very easy to clean it, but the real difficult part for this body shell, I will show you in a minute. Obviously this is an optional part. Some people don't want to do it, but I usually try to have the vents open if I can. Okay. Hi guys, had again some problems with my iPhone storage, so I'm recording this one now with my iPad. First of all, what I did, I removed all the seam lines using the sanding sticks and the sanding sponges. It took me some time, but it's not done yet. And what I want to show you is that, first of all, as I told you before, these vents have to be opened, so we need to work them out. And also this part here, although it is nicely done, okay, there's quite a lot of flush inside the vents. So I woke them one of the parts here, so the left side. Now I'm going to do the right one. So what I did, I took carefully my X-Acto knife and I try first of all to make them perfect, not at once, but I try to remove the plastic, the excess plastic. Slowly, because they are also a bit fragile. Once you remove this plastic, you can easily take some sanding sticks to smooth them out. So let's see it here. At the same time, I try to clean some seam lights who are very close to the edges. And with the tip of the X-Acto knife blade, you can clean them up. So try to look to make them look square. To clean this one, and think that's okay. I think it's much better now. Okay, and I also try to open up these panel lines. So actually I did this side here, all the left hand side, and so what I usually do, I take this Tamiya scraper. I think this is a 0.2, and try to scrape them carefully first. You see, it removes a lot of plastic. So this Tamiya scraper, I think is one of the best, because you can keep it like a pencil, and it's a very nice to hold it like a pen, and it's very stable. You have to take your time when you do the scribing, because you cannot easily scratch it, and then you have to correct this one by first use some you know, filer, and then you need to sand it, and then you do the work. So some people, they don't enjoy this part of the building process, but honestly for me it's one of the parts that I enjoy a lot, because it's the, I believe it's the most important part of the process before painting. Because if you don't do a good job here, then all the mistakes, inaccuracies will be seen after the painting process, and then it's very difficult to correct them. You have to start from the very beginning, and you don't want to do that. So you take your time to go slowly. And the end is very rewarding because you can have a nice, clean, smooth body to work. Work this part here, so that's okay. I need to go to these fenders here. So this is deepening the panel lines. This is one of the steps that I always do in my builds, because I apply a lot of layers of paint, primer paint and varnish, and usually it's a 2K varnish, which is quite thick. And if you don't open them up, then you lose all these panel lines at the end. And once they are nicely done, you can also put some panel line washes, okay, to make all these panel lines pop out. To go to this the door panels here. They already look much nicer, if you can see here. Pretty hot here. Cyprus, it's at more than 35 degrees Celsius, but there's a lot of humidity also, so it's very sticky. And when you're wearing these optimizers, you immediately start sweating. So, oops, you see? Here's when you say this the place for the mirrors. I think we could also deepen these panel lines as well a bit. is a nasty seam line. It needs to be removed. So there are three small areas that needs to be also need to dip this. So this is about the fuel cap here, and I think for this one I can use this one, which is this is tri-tool from Hasegawa. Try to make this ellipsoid here. Take some time. Let me see. She's starts to become much better. Now for the other one here for the keyholes. It will take some. I think I will do this one off camera because it's very delicate. So one other steps what I usually do always, because I will wash them up, you know. I will use some running tap water to wash them, but I always use some of this. Not this one, but this extra thin cement. Okay. Inside these panel lines, because this will eliminate all this dust and smooth them out. Okay. Okay.